Hi and welcome back to Trinity Stamps YouTube channel. My name is Emily Hassler and I'm so happy to be here again showing you two new cards. The stamp set that I'm going to use today is called Hello Sweet Friend and it has these adorable images and I absolutely love the fonts in this stamp set. I'm going to use the large stamp in this set and I'm going to use my Mini Misty to make sure I get a perfect impression when I'm stamping this out. I'm using ink called Memento Tuxedo Black and that is friendly with alcohol markers as I'm going to use these today. I went on to Pinterest and looked for a color combination and this was the color combination that I decided to use and you can see it up in the right corner. And also you could see the markers I used. These markers are called Spectrum Noir markers and they are pretty much like Copics but a little bit more less expensive, I would say. They are a little bit cheaper to get your hands on, especially if you live in Europe. And I decided that I was going to use two shades of every color here just to create a little bit more of an interest. And since I'm no expert at coloring, I decided not to leave this part in. You can watch other YouTubers here on Trinity Stamps that are a lot better on coloring than me, so please check those videos out too. After I colored everything in, I run this through my Big Shot machine with a coordinating dice, like coordinating die, I would say. And after that, I decided to start with my background. I wanted this to have a focal point and to ground my image a little bit. So I went in with some Hero Arts inks and I started out with soft granite and I just used a mini blending tool here to create a focal point. Then I used a stencil, this is a brick stencil, just to create a little bit more of an interest. This is a harder stencil, I would say, against that more feminine and soft coloring that we did. And I also think that is good because they help each other to bring out the best in these two images. And then I decided that I wanted some splatters on my background too. So I took some black acrylic paint and water it down and use my brush here to mix it together. And it actually turned out to be a little bit too thick to make the splatters, so I decided to go in with a little bit more water here and then try to blend it together again. And this time it worked out a little bit better. And you can see the fine mist of splatters that you get when you use this technique. After I'm happy with the result, I let that dry and decided to keep working on the sentiment for this card. I used the sentiment from the same stamp set as the flower image came from. And this one is saying, "My sweet friend." And I was thinking about using some of the larger sentiments in this set too, but I decided against it because I think this looked more finished and good with just one small sentiment heat embossed in white onto black cardstock. This is one of my go-to looks and something I use on nearly every card. And I really like how this turned out this time too. Now I'm just playing around with the placement of my focal image and also decided to go with a gray card base here. This is a dark gray card base. And I also decided to pop my focal image up with some foam tape. And then I used a Dries foam strip to create some dimension on my sentiment here, and I placed it on top of the focal image just to make it more to a whole piece, if that makes sense. For embellishment I used a black glaze pen and that creates some more interest to the flower centers, and I also decided to go in with some, you will see it here soon, a glitter sparkling glitter pen and just coat the flowers with it. I also, you could see me adhere some sequins. These sequins are from Trinity Stamps and they are called Rock Candy Confet. confetti, and they are super cute and sparkly, and I really like them. I've been using them a lot lately onto my cards. And for my second card, the thought I had when I created this one was that it was going to be a little bit more of a masculine card, or actually this could be a feminine card too, but I decided that I wanted to be a little bit more clean and simple. This time I used the stamp directly with an acrylic block, and I used the same ink. It's a Memento Tuxedo Black, and I wanted to create a background pattern here. And I always, when I create background patterns, I want these to be off-centered and going off the page and not being an even number, if that makes sense. You can see I stamped out 5 of them, and I think that makes it so it looks a little bit better. This is a large roll of post-it tape, and I used the coordinating dies and die cut it out, and then I'm going to cover up all of these images with these post-it notes, because we're going to do some ink blending over this panel. And I actually die cutted just 4 of them, and you can see I'm going to cut off the excess here and reuse it on the flower image down below. So now all of my colors, all of my stamping are covered. I'm going to go in with some Distress Oxide Fossilized Amber. And I really like this color. It's the perfect fall color, I think. And I can see myself using this color together with some orange and red and green colors to create some stunning fall leaves or backgrounds for fall cards. So that was something I had in the back of my mind when I created this card also, that I wanted it to be a little bit more fall color themed. So here you can see how the background turned out, and I absolutely love the result. I think I can create a lot more backgrounds like this. And for the sentiment, I used another Trinity stamp set called Caffeine Sentiments. And I used some black cardstock here again to ink this up with some Versa Mark ink and coat it again with some white embossing powder. And I heat setted it off camera, and you can see my daughter's hand here. She was actually my little helper today, or should I say destroyer, but she was she was kind of nice when she was here. When I had heat embossed 3 of the same sentiments, you can see they say happy birthday. I'm going to assemble this card, and I'm using some Nouveau glue and adhering it down flat to the card panel, or the card base I would say. And this is just a top folded A2 sized card base, and it's made of Anina 110 pound cardstock, and that is something I always use for my card bases because it has a nice weight to it. For the sentiments, I used a T-ruler just to place this down straight, but I actually decided to go ahead and take them away and do it myself, just eyeballing it. It was a little bit easier, I decided. Then I went in with some sequins here. These are the same as I used in the first card. It's the Rock Candy Confetti mix from Trinity Stamps. And I thought this was the perfect bling for this card, to make it not too feminine and pretty. I also decided to go in with the same glaze pen and do exactly the same thing as I did on the first card, just to create a little bit more interest to these flowers and make them look a little bit more finished. If you like this card, please give it a thumb up and subscribe to this YouTube channel. You can also subscribe to my channel. I will leave a link down below for that one. And I will see you next Friday. Bye!